Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a whale watch trip. It started from this traffic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, the skipper brave and sure. 10 passengers set sail that day on a whale watching tour, a 3-hour tour.
First mate's log, sea date 21-34-59-46.78. I forget it. Skipper says conditions are perfect for spotting a whale today. No wind, no rain, no fog.
As I've watched it over my time, it used to be kind of rare to see a whale, you know. But even in the last 4 or 5 years, well, it seemed like there's more and more and more whales. You'll see a lot of whales today.
Great, Skipper. We'll be outside looking. And remember, when you see a whale, yell,
"Oh, oh, oh!"
No, 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 no. You're supposed to say,
"There she blows!"
That's better. But wait a minute, that's not a whale. Oh, there she blows. And remember to look for the spout of water as they surface.
I've had them kind of push the boat a little bit, you know, and rub them. I've never seen us injure a whale. You know, I always worry about cutting their back or something. I've never seen that happen. We're careful to just drift when we're real close to them.
Oh, I'm just found it right there.
They're just awed by the size of them, you know. And I think we're all getting more possessive of our planet. You know, we're getting more possessive of the environmental impact that we humans are having on nature. It's getting heavier every year, bigger loads. I got another load this afternoon of maybe 15 or 20, and so does all the other boats. And it varies with the weather, too.
Yeah, you're right, Skipper. Speaking of the weather, it's getting a little rough out here. Maybe we should head back in.
When finally they made it home, they wound up on this sand. They had to make the best of things and started digging clams. And started digging clams.
Well, Brad, if we're going to survive here, we're going to have to learn how to dig clams. Razor clams is what I think is here, rather than cockle or horse or butter clams.
All right.
And,
what do we do?
Well, we've got to make the clam respond to us. We'll tap the sand, we'll cause the clam to flex. When he flexes, he literally pulls the shell down around a digger that is filled full of water, and he'll squirt. And as he squirts, then he'll cause the dimple to be in the sand.
We're not finding any yet, Larry.
Well, we will.
Just when I thought we were gonna starve.
There.
Aha, success.
Hey, see the dimple or the
indentation? Yeah, I saw the clam too.
What a small one.
Is that's a small clam that's by clam small standards?
Exactly, this clam prior to the parasite nicks that devastated our beaches here in early 80s and still today. That clam would be that much longer, that much wider.
First mate's log. We've been here almost 20 minutes and we've only caught one clam, which doesn't surprise me considering my luck. What is surprising is the number of other stranded castaways on this beach, nearly 30,000. I wonder what they're all doing here.
That's a good question. Grow up doing it and it's just kind of natural.
It's the sport of it, and they taste better.
Catching a lot?
Yeah.
How many you got so far?
I don't know.
Whole bunch, huh? You like coming out here?
Yeah.
How come?
I don't know.
And something else I've noticed, Skipper, there seems to be so many ways to stalk the elusive razor clam. The violent approach. The psychological eye contact approach. The make them think they're seeing double method. Seems to work better than our system. How many of you two caught so far? I'm so embarrassed.
I tell you, sure is an awful lot of work just to dig up one of these guys. He doesn't even look like he'd make a very big meal, but the rest of these folks can do it. So can I. Excuse me, I gotta go find lunch.
We know that he looks silly, but don't laugh right in his face. Just realize this city boy is such a hopeless case.